ביבי has a new message for voters.
1948, בן גוריון עומד בפני החלטה גורלית, הקמת מדינת ישראל. מזכיר המדינה האמריקני התנגד בתוקף. בן גוריון, בניגוד לעמדת מחלקת המדינה האמריקנית, מכריז על הקמת המדינה.
Don't ever listen to Washington. Another sham in a long line of shows, but Israel's Benjamin Netanyahu has been called out for another performance. Leaked cables show Netanyahu's Iran bomb claim was contradicted by Mossad intelligence. The information available was that 20% enrichment was a top ceiling for Iran's nuclear program. So the red line was fake.
Where's Iran? Iran's completed the first stage. Took them many years, but they completed it, and they're 70% of the way there. Now they're well into the second stage.
The bomb scare was a fail, maybe because...
Ladies and gentlemen, what I've told you now is not based on secret information. It's not based on military intelligence.
But maybe it should be. Next time, consult with Mossad before coming on stage. A viral video of a Jewish journalist and reaction to him walking around Paris in a kippah is now under fire for being exaggerated. Zika Klein walked the French capital for 10 hours and published a couple of minutes of it to suggest anti-Semitism has reached critical levels. The question is, what happened in the other 9 hours and 58 minutes, and did it portray reality? He was spit on, name-called, and scorned. Joining us in the now is Richard Silverstein, Seattle-based political blogger. Richard, I hope you can hear me. What are your concerns about this video?
Well, many concerns, really, from the beginning to the end. The fact that, you know, the video is about 2 minutes long, and there really is only, like, less than 1 minute in which he is mistreated. Also, if you, anyone who speaks French would dispute some of the translations, he used a mic that was not part of the video camera that he was using, so the sound is both poor and difficult to decipher. So we're trusting, he doesn't speak French either, so we're trusting a translation that an unknown person did, which is supposedly transcribing the comments that were made against him. Also, he himself, Zvika Klein, has a long history of being an ideological spokesperson for both the Israeli army and a religious settler movement in Israel. He has used tweets from the Jewish Defense League in France in his reporting, and he's just a suspect character, I think. And he had an agenda. The agenda was, as an Israeli, he wanted to go into Paris and prove that it was a hostile place for Jews, so that the Jews of France would consider making Aliyah and moving to Israel, which is the agenda of the Israeli government.
It's interesting that you bring up the Jewish Defense League, because Zika, to us, actually condemns some of their actions in Paris. You say that he's referred to some of his tweets. I want to listen to what Zika Klein had to say to us in the Now last week. Now, the video only shows a couple of minutes out of what was 10 hours of walking. What else did you experience on the streets?
Right. Well, if you want, we could have left all the 10 hours and have you watch it, but it wouldn't be as interesting. At the end of the day, there was also parts that we weren't able to put in for technical reasons. We filmed with a candid camera on the back of a cameraman who walked in front of me. So a lot of it, a lot of parts that were actually even more, sometimes more extreme than what we showed, weren't understood on camera. And it wouldn't contribute in any way. Certain parts weren't filmed, or the sound was problematic, so we couldn't use it. But on the other hand, I could say the majority majority of the time, there was just like heads turning and looking at me as something that's strange and out of place in the neighborhoods that I was walking in.
All right, Zvika Klein there with us in the Now last week, basically talking about the sound problems, which you mentioned. He didn't say anything about the translation, but he did ensure that most of the time people passing by were shaking their heads or looking at him in a very disapproving way. Why is this dangerous for the people that saw this video? Because it did go viral.
Yep, it was featured all over the media and European media, BBC, Channel 4. It just kind of like took off. And that was why I wanted to write about it, because I think it really is a sham that is, he basically had an ideological point that he wanted to prove, and he used this to try to do so. But, I think everything about the project was fake. He went into these neighborhoods with a security guard who he doesn't mention, and he had a cameraman in front of him. So there are three totally suspicious unknown individuals walking through these neighborhoods. And one of them looks like an Israeli settler, basically. So I don't know what he would expect to happen. If I wrote in my blog that if he dressed in a keffiyeh and walked through a settlement on the West Bank, he would probably be stoned and be treated far worse. So, these things happen all over the world. There's lots of prejudice and discrimination in the United States against minorities, and in Europe against minorities, and in your country there's some, and in Israel there's some. So, I don't get what the point is really here.
I'm going to interrupt you, Richard, because I want to get to another point. I also want to say that I do think that even in the minute we saw, there was some disturbing footage in that video. But you do have a point that all religions have their problems, especially in Europe, especially in wake of some of the latest developments we've seen. I want to take a look at a similar video with a Muslim man walking through Italy. Richard, pretty much showing basically the same kind of offensive comments. I have to be honest, I'm not sure how long that video was. We've tried to be in touch with the creator of that video. But just briefly, how can we trust any of these kinds of videos, which are clearly trying to get a certain point across?
Well, that video, I think, is to me more interesting, because he walked through the main streets of Milan. He didn't choose a Jewish neighborhood, and he was treated similarly to Zvika Klein in Paris. I think the technical aspects, production values of that were much better. He clearly had the video and the audio done by a single piece of equipment, and you could hear what the people were saying, and you could trust that the translations were correct. So to me, that's a more authentic production than Zvika Klein's. But as I said, you can get any response that you want. If you walk through the streets of Birmingham or Paris or the West Bank, you'll find huge levels of prejudice. The history of prejudice in Europe and in other countries of people being killed for their religious beliefs and violence against them is very full. So I don't think, Zvika Klein wants the world to think that the Jews have a monopoly, the Israelis have a monopoly on suffering and prejudice and discrimination against them. And while that's true, I don't think that they have a monopoly. We have to fight against this, whether it's prejudice against Muslims or prejudice against Jews or Israelis. It's equally pernicious in both circumstances.
Richard Silverstein, Seattle-based political blogger, with us in the Now from Seattle.